Alright, this little thing is a Mercury switch. So, back prior to 2003, Mercury switches were used in automobiles for the lighting, like courtesy lights, so like under the hood light and in the trunk light. So instead of like a push button switch, it was simply a little blob of mercury would slosh around. I can feel it in there. Would blob around and it would complete the circuit. And anyways, that's this little thing contains mercury. And I forget what it is, but one little whatever can contaminate a whatever lake of water. So anyways, there was a huge uproar, and manufacturers had to smarten up and stop using them. And what really made me hear about this, these are from years ago. I put them in my toolbox, and I knew that someday I'd get rid of them by like one of these programs. Anyways, this came to the shop today. It was the switch out, and basically this little thing is the whole kit and everything. Now, what I find very interesting is, they've really collected over 500,000 mercury switches to date, and that's 450 kilograms of mercury. Wow, that's a lot that they've actually retrieved. I would have thought it would have been a lot less, but basically what really came to light was there was rumors flying around that some of the larger auto recyclers were paying up to $20, like the U-Picket yards and stuff like that. They'd pay you $20 if you were able to go in the yard and pull mercury switches. So I heard that, and that was back probably 10 years ago. And I was just like, I was like, wow, man. They must be really bad if they're willing to pay to get them, or maybe I feared that maybe the auto recyclers were gonna get fined or something like that for not getting them. But anyways, I'm happy to do my helping for the environment, and I was just amazed at all the vehicles that they came in. I would have thought that they would have come in a lot more vehicles. Maybe this is just the short list. But there's nothing Volkswagen on it, but there was a Cadillac, but that would make sense. I knew that the trunk one and the 56 Cadillac had a mercury switch, but they used to just bust those open. They would sometimes they wouldn't open up with the screwdriver, but what was really surprising to me was the ABS G-force sensor modules, and then here's all these things. Now, I didn't even know it, but yeah, there was a 4x4 B series pickup. Well, 95 to 2001, I think. I had the older style, so it didn't even have it, but I got thinking, I'm like, oh, that Mazda, actually I do remember seeing something like that. But anyways, yeah, I remember seeing these mercury switch things everywhere, and I thought, well, I better do my part for the environment, and I have these ones and whatnot. So anyways, yeah, they're happy to do my part. What was it? It was one thing over here. I can't find it. So yeah, you can just you can ask them for another pail. You can get another one. Anyways, yeah, it was very interesting to read up on all this. I didn't even know that the ABS modules had it. I don't know where it is. There was another pamphlet. I don't know. Oh, here it is. Yeah, these, so it's only the switches. The GM light switches, yeah, there was a lot of those. I do remember that. Yeah, 2002 and older, it says. Yeah, these Ford light switches, I remember. I think that's where those came from. Yeah, Cadillac light switch. I'm pretty sure that I've seen that somewhere, but there's also, this is what they don't accept, but they do have mercury in them. So here's like common stuff that does not have mercury in it. But then there's ones that, they won't accept vials or liquid mercury even. It's just these that they're after. So anyways, food for thought. I just thought that I'd share that with you guys. Thought it was a great thing to do. And I got the paper the other day and I looked at it and I was like, oh man, I better get working on the derby car. It's about that time of year. And I thought, well, I better get on it. So today I moved the derby car. And I think we'll be working on it sometime soon. You know, time pending and whatnot.